BBC introducing
in Hereford and Worcester.
Now, this next artist is an 18-year-old electronic music producer from Weobley, which is between Kington and Leominster. He's just gone left college, having studied music, and he's awaiting his A-level results on Thursday. Best of luck. His real name is Josh Anthony. Goes under the name of Seasons.
This track's called Decay, and I wrote it last year. Okay, this track's called Revelation.
unsigned, undiscovered,
and under the radar music.
Well, that's the hurricane that we were promised. During the space of walking from the BBC tent here to this little teepee that we discovered, which is probably about 5 metres away, we've had all sorts of sun, and now it's started to hammer down with rain. We're next to the water zorbing, and I'm with Seasons. That looks awesome.
I would like to do that myself. I think I'm going to do that right after this, actually.
I'm trying to see what that says on the sign next to it. Today's weather, and then there's like pictures of
wind
stuff.
Wind speed.
Is that what it is?
I think I can see it says wind speed and direction and okay. Stuff.
All right. I'm going to describe you for people at home. You've got a baseball cap on. You've got long, dark hair. You've got a black top and a black T-shirt. And you've got some skater boy type shoes on. It looks like you should be listening to grunge music. How did you get into electronica?
I don't listen to a lot of electronic music. I mainly listen to metal music, which explains the outfit. I'm just much more into producing than playing instruments in bands. When I was about 13, I started making electronic music on my laptop, and it just kind of built from there.
Don't like people who listen to metal music hate electronic music, isn't it? You're kind of breaking the trend there.
I don't know, people can think what they want about music because everyone has different tastes, so they can hate if they want.
I'm loving the shoes, by the way.
Thank you.
Now, I nearly bought a pair like that, but my other half stopped me and said, you don't own a skateboard. Do you own a skateboard?
I own a skateboard.
Okay.
I don't
she was right then, I can't own one.
Yeah.
I was hoping you were going to say no and I would have been able to go back to her. I said, look, I'm buying those shoes.
You don't need to use the skateboard, just buy a skateboard and get the shoes.
Oh, yeah, I never
just walk around with one and just look cool.
Get one of the cool ones, wall mount it, have it instead of a poster or something like that. Yeah, okay. So when you say you're listening to bands, what sort of bands?
I mostly listen to post-hardcore music, kind of like Ask Alexandra, Motionless in White. You probably won't never heard it.
I haven't. But when it comes to writing dance music, that is the kind of bit where you can suddenly go away and make remixes and samples and stuff like that. Have you sampled those bands?
I haven't sampled those bands.
Have I just planted an idea there?
That's what I'm going to do when I get home here. It's going to be my next hit.
And just tell me a little bit about the whole kind of songwriting process. How long does it take to write a track from start through to finish?
It would take a lot longer, but I'm just very impatient, so I'll probably spend about 3 hours just making all the bare melodies and chord progressions and drums and all that. And then I spend like about a week just listening to it over and over and tweaking and polishing because I just want to make sure everything's as good as I can get it.
And another big difference between bands and people who are writing electronica is you can walk into a tent at a festival and you can see them playing drums, you can see the singer, you can see the bassist, the guitarist. I don't think people necessarily understand kind of what's going on stage. So just describe what you were doing to get the sound out of the two speakers at the front.
Right, if I had like 10 arms, I would play every single layer of my song at once, but obviously I can't. So I have what's called a launch pad. It's a grid controller. I can map different melodies that I've already written to different buttons, and I can cue them whenever I want. So you probably saw me pressing a lot of buttons. That was me cueing all the different loops that I've made. And then I'll usually play the main part on the keyboard as well.
So without any of those buttons, there is no sound.
No, that's what I was right about, because during practicing this week, I had one day where my buttons just all crashed and didn't do anything, so I was praying that didn't happen.
That is the danger, isn't
it? And it didn't happen, so I'm happy.
But it always happens to everyone. It's like people are always worried about their computer crashing. But you know what? How many gigs have I seen spoiled and they stop halfway through because they've broken a string?
Yeah.
So you've just gone and finished college.
I was at Hereford Sixth Form College, yes. Music tech, maths, further maths and computing.
Okay, why maths and computing?
I'm good at maths, so that's why I originally did maths, but I'm hoping to do computer science at university, so that's why I picked those subjects.
Which helps when you write electronica.
Yeah,
and especially maths,
yes.
Bizarrely.
I think it does, something to do with the structure of the music.
So you're finding out on Thursday, good luck for your exam results. And then, if they do end up in your favour, where will you be going?
Hopefully University of Bristol. I was going to go into music, but I just want to keep it as a hobby, keep it fun. And then just do computer science, writing programs and things, perhaps for a job.
And have you done many gigs like this?
This is my first. My
really?
First gig. Yes.
Well done.
Thanks a lot.
Well, it looks like this teepee is going to blow away at any given point. I did actually see when we were in that tent earlier on, I said, oh, did someone just take a picture? And no, it was a bolt of lightning. So I think I'm going to move somewhere a little bit safer.
Yeah,
so
great.
Yeah, great set.
Thanks a lot.
And thanks once again.
Cheers.
BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester.
With Andrew Marston.
Be part of it.
Okay, this track's called Equilibrium. I wrote it in January this year.
Oh, melody.
Okay, this song's called Summer Vibe.
Introducing
in Hereford and Worcester
with Andrew Marston.
So you said Seasons would have been brilliant here at Lakefest about 11 p.m. last night. Was it kicking off a little bit?
It's the time of night. People have had a drink. They want to dance, and that was excellent music. Very, very good.
Can you believe that was his first ever gig?
Really?
Just no, starting out, excellent. Bedroom producer, whipped him out and brought him along here.
Okay.
Oh. And what did you make of it?
You could put that out, and you know, you'd think, okay, David Guetta, he's going to be a star in the making, I would hope. I think he's a good ear for talent.
Oh, is he your first time at Lakefest?
No, this is number three. Well, the origins, it was an afternoon festival, just a cider festival. I think the Wurzels played.
Yeah, it was the Roving Crows, who are one of our local artists, Paul and Caitlin, have put this festival on. Haven't they done a smashing job? Four main stages, so much going on with the kids, the family, so much dancing.
I haven't seen so many families at a festival and loving it as well. You know, there's so much to do. There's the water sports, there's the bungee runs.
I wanted to go on everything, but unfortunately, I haven't had time. Unfortunately for me, probably fortunately for everyone else trying to see me waters all.
Oh, Betty. Well, yeah, at least when it's raining, you're going to keep drying us all, aren't you? And with the water as well, I mean, hey, it's raining already. Does it matter if you get a bit wetter? You know, have a bit of fun with it. They've done such a good job now. They've got all these tents. You can go in, stay dry. I mean, a lot of festivals don't have the cover. You know, it rains. You have to sit out and get wet or not watch the bands. Whereas here, you've got these tents. And sometimes as well, it does make you more inclined to sort of drift into a tent and see the new talents.
It makes it easier with kids, I guess.
Oh, definitely, yeah. I mean, the kids are just loving it, aren't they? They're really having a good time.
So I've been eyeing up all the water sports that are going on here at Lakefest this weekend. I'm joined by the man who runs it all. Introduce yourself.
Hiya, I'm Tom.
And you own all of the tubes and the banana boats and the kayaks and everything I've seen going on the lake at Lakefest. How long have you been doing this?
I've been here for the last 11, 12 years.
So you've seen Lakefest come from a one-day afternoon cider festival into what you see now.
Well, it's just grown in size over the years and popularity. There's so many people here this year, it's amazing.
Do you yourself get to see any of the bands, anyone that you've been eyeing up on the lineup this year to see?
I love it all, it's brilliant.
Keeps you happy, everyone's having a great time out on your lake with all the water sports available, that's awesome.
We're listening to most of it as we're down there rather than up on the field here.
A unique situation to listen to festival music, that, and yeah. Do you see the worst? Because this started out as a one-day cider afternoon. It was the Roving Crows, Paul and Caitlin, and the Wurzels. How was that initial event?
The Wurzels are amazing. They've been back here since, and we've listened to them in other places locally because I know they're a local group. They're just good, fun people to listen to, really happy guys. It's always a laugh when you go and watch them.
And I'm definitely probably going to have a go on those water sorbs in a bit, so watch out for me. No pictures, though, please.
Listen to the best interviews online. bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing.
This is my last track. It's called Clouds. You can download my music for free from my Bandcamp page, seasonsofficial.bandcamp.com. You can just get it all free on there.
Unsigned, undiscovered,
and under the radar music
with Andrew Marston.